Hello Automation Animal Lovers, welcome back to KT Sessions. And in today's video, we will dive into the JSON Object Manager package in Automation Animal A360. In one of our previous videos, we explored the JSON package and its actions and how it can be used within A360 to handle JSON data. If you haven't seen that video yet, I recommend checking it out to get a solid foundation. Today, we will build on that knowledge and focus on the JSON Object Manager, JSON or JavaScript object notation. Is a lightweight data interchange format that is easy for humans to read and write, and easy for machines to parse and generate. We will go through practical examples to see how we can use the JSON Object Manager to simplify data handling in our automation workflows. This will help us create more dynamic and flexible bots that can interact with various APIs and data sources. Like guys, after this JSON videos, we will create videos on the APIs. So stay tuned as we dive into these examples and uncover the power of JSON Object Manager in Automation Anywhere A360. So guys, let me open control room. Let me create a task bot for this one, JSON Object Manager. So in actions, we can search for that package, JSON Object Manager. So we have this initialize query, and there is one more action which is available in the default package. Let me change the package version. So let me select 1.2 and change version. So in this version 1.2, we can see one more action which is sent. So there are total three actions: initialize, query, and set. Initialize, as its name suggests, we will initialize the JSON here, and in the next action, query, we can get the data with the help of a query. When we apply a query or when we apply a expression, we can get particular data, or we can extract the particular data with the help of a query or expression. And the next one is set. So we will use this action to set the value of a particular key or element in JSON. So we will see the use of all these three actions one by one. And this is the JSON which we are going to use in our session. And it contains one array which is employee, and this employee array contains two elements or the value of two employees. This is the value of first employee and this is the value of second employee. We can say details. It contains like ID, name, position, department, salary, and joining date. Similarly, it contains same details for another employee. So for example, if we want to get a specific details, means if we want to get the detail of first employee or the name of the second employee or the salary of the second employee, so how can we get that? All these things we will see in this video. So let me copy this JSON. So first of all, we will go to this initialize session and initialize action, and here we will give the name of the session, for example default. And here we can give our JSON. Now return string. So we will get the data in a string. I have created a sample string variable, and I will store the result in this. Now the next one is query. So how can we apply a query? For example, I want to get the department of this employee. So this department, it is for the first employee or the first record. So this employee is an array employees. For that, we need to give the expression. I will type employees. And as this is an array, So I want to get the data of the first impulse. I will give 0 here because the index will start from 0 and dot the department. I will give department here. So employees 0 dot department, and we can save the data in a variable department. Okay, let me create and select, and I will use a message box to print the result message box. And let me disable this set action. When we go to message box, we can print that this department value. Okay, so department value is engineering. So we still get engineering in the message box. So here we go, we can see engineering. Similarly, if we want to get the data of second employee, for example, if we were to get the ID, so I will go to this query again, and here we need to give the index 1, and here we will give the element name ID. And we can run the process. So if your JSON doesn't contain any array and it contains simple element, in that case also, you can get the direct value. Means if your JSON is like this, ID 1. For example, your JSON is like this. It contains simple elements or simple values. So we got this message box. It contains 2. This is the ID of the second employee. Let me close this. And if we want to get the value of this name, so first let me use this JSON. I'm using this JSON, and in query now, no need to give this employee or something, just we can give ID directly. So ID is 1 here. So here we can see 1. So this is how we can get the value of any element from the JSON. Now, let me show you one more thing. For example, if we have this array and it contains three data of 3 employees, ID 1, ID 2, and ID 3, you can see. So it contains 3 records. So when we go to this one and we give this ID 1, ID 2, ID 3, and in the query, so what we will do is we will add 0. Sorry, we will add employees dot length and brackets. So now we will get the result in the department only, and when we can run it for. So it will give the length of the array C 3 because it contains 3 records. So this is how we can get the length of that particular array, and then we can use 0, 1, 2, and there are total three employees. So we can get the data accordingly. We can use the for loop and all those things to get the value of each employee. So first we need to get the length. Now let's see the use of this set action. With the help of this query, we can get the value, and with the help of this set, we can set the value, means we can assign a particular value. So again, we are using this same JSON, and in set, what we will do is, for example, we want to update the salary of this employee. Okay, so this is the first employee, means employee 0. So what we will do is we will go to this set action, and here we will assign the same session and the path to a JSON element. Here we need to give the path of that element, means employees 0 dot salary. So for it is 75,000 only. Now what we will need to assign, we want to update it to 90,000. Okay, and we can use, we can save this updated JSON in our department or in somewhere we can save it. Now what we will do is we will use again this action. See, we got one JSON, we have changed the value of a particular element, and now we want to get the value of that element. See, do one thing, let me show you. See, first of all, we got one, we got some JSON data, and we have created a session default, and in the next line, we are going to extract the salary of the employee. So this is the original salary. So we will paste it, I mean, we will print in the line third, means the existing salary. Okay, now what we have done in the fourth line, we have updated the salary to 90,000. And in the line number 5, we are again extracting the salary. And in line number 6, we are printing the our updated salary. So here we will write updated salary. So let me run the bot. Here we go, we got the first salary or the existing salary 75,000 in line number 3. Let me close this. And here we can see updated salary is 90,000. So with the help of this set statement or set object, set action, we can update the value of a particular element. And we can use this in our task board. So guys, just you need to get the expression of that particular element for which you want to get the value or you want to set the value. Thank you guys for watching this video. Do let me know still you have any doubt or any question in this video or in any other topic. We will guide you for sure. Thank you guys so much.